I'm very happy to be here with you. Such a large gathering of Korean companies in India is actually a global story. I take this opportunity to welcome all of you to India. The relationship between India and Korea dates back centuries. It is believed that an Indian princess traveled to Korea and became a queen in Korea. We are also bound by our Buddhist traditions. Our Nobel laureates, Rabindranath Tagore, composed a poem, Lamb of the East, in 1929, about Korea's glorious past and its bright future. Bollywood films are also very popular in Korea. And at the Pro Kabaddi League in India, a few months ago, some of the loudest cheers were reserved for a Korean Kabaddi player. It is also a good coincidence that India and South Korea both celebrate their Independence Day on the 15th of August. From princess to poetry, and from Buddha to Bollywood, we have so much in common. As I have mentioned earlier, I have always been fascinated by Korea. I visited Korea when I was Chief Minister of Gujarat. I used to wonder how a country of the size of Gujarat can make such economic progress. I admire the spirit of enterprise of the Korean people. I admire the way in which they have created and sustained their global brands. From IT and electronics to oval